Hey guys, how's it going? So this year, I ended up succumbing to Black Friday because I bought something that was a Black Friday sale. I normally don't. I don't think I've ever really participated in Black Friday just because this is shopping madness and I don't really like the crowd that happens. It gets pretty insane. Like, you can see all those videos of people stampeding each other. And I think there's even some statistics that are now being ranged where it's like, these are the amount of people that died in Black Friday so far, and it was because of the crazy madness. So I'm like, whatever. But I was just browsing around Best Buy, and I was like, no way. There was like this touchscreen laptop that was being, you know, the price of it was $250. I was like, what? That's ridiculous. Well, like, it's probably Asus, so it's not a great brand of computer, but at the same time, it's still a pretty decent laptop with like 4 gigabytes of RAM. Okay, so that's not so great, but you know, decent hard drive space. It's a decent laptop, you know, and it could do a bunch of different things, and it's touchscreen for $250. So like, that touchscreen thing mattered a lot to me, just because I've used my dad's computer before, and it's Windows 8 Windows 8 operating system on a non-touchscreen computer. Just awful, man. That thing is like a tablet operating software mixed in with the old, I don't know, it's a mess. When like, so I was like, if I have a Windows computer, I want it to be a touchscreen, just because the Windows 8 operating system is designed that way. And I was like, man, that'd be really cool. And I wanted a Windows computer because like, I have a gigantic Steam library, as with a lot of people. You know, I think a lot of people have really big Steam libraries because of the sales that happen. It's like, oh my gosh, a game for $1, or this bundle of games for like $10, gonna buy it. I don't know when I'll ever play it, but alright, let's do it. So I do have a really big Steam library that's been accrued over the years, most of which I can't play because I only have a MacBook. And a lot of the games on there, I can, you know, only play on a Windows computer. And I haven't purchased a Windows product in such a long time. It's my MacBook here. This is like 4 years old. Before this MacBook, I had a MacBook. So like, it's with the computer products, I've always been, I guess, more of an Apple guy. Well, that's not true. I also have an iPhone and an iPad. So I'm definitely an Apple guy. For you know, I have my reasons for that. Mostly because the customer service experience that I had with Apple were amazing, and the customer service experience I had with Microsoft was piss poor. It's always been that way. I don't know if that's true now, but I haven't had to deal with Microsoft customer service in a long time, because I haven't had a Microsoft product in a long time. Now I do. So this is it. I haven't opened it yet, but I have it in the box still. I really like this plastic wrapping bag, by the way. For some reason, it's mirrored there, but it's like, tag plus recycle equals planet Earth with a heart. I thought that was really neat. I don't know. Anyway, so this is it. This is the little laptop that is touchscreen. So pretty cool. I'm excited. Not gonna open it here, but I'm definitely excited. And you know, I was like going around Best Buy with my friend, like looking around for it. And then we couldn't really find it. But then there was a desktop that was like really good for selling for about $300. And by really good, my standards are, you know, not that high. I'm not looking to play like, I don't know, Crysis 3 on like the highest settings or anything like that. Like, I'm not a graphics whore. I just want to be able to play PC games, especially because on Steam, PC games can get so cheap. I also have an Origins account, which is EA Origins, and when I signed up for Origins, they were doing this deal. It's like, oh, sign up for Origins and you get these 3 free games. So it's like, okay, I'm probably never gonna, you know, I don't have a Windows computer, but who knows, maybe I'll end up with one. So the first 3 games were like Spore, SimCity 4, and Battlefield 3. I was like, shit, alright, let's do it. So I got a really great, I have those games on Origins, which I can't play on my MacBook, other than Spore. Spore is now, I played a little bit on my MacBook, but my MacBook is kind of outdated with like processing power and graphics technology, whatever. So yeah, now that I have a Windows computer, that is accessible to me. Plus, you know, I mean, Windows is generally like, I don't know. For everything else, I'm not sure what I would be using that computer for. I do have this MacBook, but it's nice to have another laptop, I guess. You know, this is an old MacBook. I have no idea when this is going to die out on me. It's 4 years old, and I haven't really taken a great care of it. So it's still running. I'm using the webcam of my MacBook, so it's still going, but I have no idea. If it craps out on me, at least I have this. But yeah, so the first, I was in Best Buy for a while, couldn't find anything. We just browsed around a bit, and then I went to a different Best Buy, and like I was like, whoa, this is so like crazy. I went to the Union Square Best Buy. I have no idea why I went there, because that's like the most crowded one in New York City. I make wise decisions, right? But that means also that it's the most fully stocked. They have the most stuff, so that was awesome. But the waiting line was ridiculous. Anyway, I went around, I was like, this is not working, I'm not finding it. So I just went up to one of the Best Buy guys. I was like, okay, so do you know, like, I looked online, I saw this Asus laptop. There's this touchscreen laptop that's selling for $240. Or do you know where I can find it? And he's like, what's the laptop? It's like, it's an Asus laptop. He's like, he cut me short. He's like, you can ask over there in the cash register. They'll find it for you. It was very rude. I don't know. He also seemed like this was like his first day on the job or something. Because I noticed like him interacting with the coworkers, and his supervisor or the manager like yelled at him and berated him for something about lunch break or whatever. So not a great guy that I got to talk with him firsthand. And then I went over there. The line was really, really long. And during the wait, one of the customers was just like, oh my gosh, how long? It's like, is there a faster, shorter line than this? And one of the Best Buy employees was like, that's actually the shortest line in the store right now. And she's like, what? You're kidding me. And she just stormed out of the store, angry. I was like, wow. But I did wait a long time. I think because one of the cash register computer was having a problem, and then another cashier, there was this customer who couldn't speak English all that well, but was like asking like 100 questions, and then another cash register, the employee was trying to really sell this product and just going on and on and on all about the product, and so it was three cash registers and they're taking forever. It took me like 30 minutes to actually get there. At this point, I don't even know if they have what I want in stock. So I go up there, I'm just like, so online I saw this Asus computer that's touchscreen, that's $250. And like I was hoping like he would know what I was talking about and maybe look it up. He's like, oh yeah, we have that right here. He's like, this is it. I was like, oh my gosh, like I want to buy that. So that, and he was really cool. We had a pretty small, I you know, people were waiting behind me, so didn't want to take too much of my time, too much of their time. So had a small like 30-second chat, friendly chat, and then took it. Oh, and then the person next in line came out, was like, oh my gosh, like she also had a laptop. He's like, is that better or is this better? So hers was actually more expensive than mine, same brand, but not touchscreen. I don't know, it's a little bigger too. That's probably why. Maybe the screen size makes it more expensive, I don't know. But the employee was like, well, this is actually touchscreen. And she's like, oh, I want that now. Can I trade? It's like it was pretty funny, like how, you know, like my purchase kind of also wanted her to take my purchase anyway. Yeah, so that's how I succumbed to Black Friday this year, which I usually do not do, but I thought it was such an amazing deal. And now I have access to, finally, in a long time, I actually have access to the games I purchased on Steam. And whatever other things that this laptop, I will try to make it as useful to me as possible. It is a kind of I don't think it's a frivolous purchase now. It is computer, so its utility is much more broad, you know. It's not like I bought a PlayStation Vita, which only purpose would be to play games. You know, I wanted to do that. Like, I was like, oh, I do want to play PlayStation Vita for some reason. But if I do that, the only thing I'm using that is really just to play games And right now, that's not what I need, because, you know, I have school, internship, job to worry about. It's like another console wouldn't be healthy for me. Not something I should waste my money on right now. But I think this was a pretty okay decision. I didn't spend that much money. So it's $250. I also took a 1-year warranty on it, which was like $60 with tax and everything. And the antivirus software, they gave it for free, but it's 6 months, so it's whatever. All that turned out to be about $330, I think, which I think is pretty damn good for a touchscreen laptop. I have to see how crappy this computer is, though. I don't know. It's such a cheap computer. I'm not sure the quality of it, but at least I have a Windows computer that is touchscreen for that cheap. So I think that was amazing. Anyway, that's my Black Friday story of the year. I know it was pretty kind of dry or whatever, but yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.